A homecoming one Husker will never forget.
One tackle left Budge Porter paralyzed from the neck down in 1976.
Now, decades later, life is about to get a little easier thanks to kindness of strangers, contractors, and Budge's close friends. KETV News Watch 7's Natalie Glucklich joins us live now.
Rob, Budge Porter is one of those people who just remains positive despite all the odds stacked against him, and that is something that has not gone unnoticed. So tonight, a labor of love that is sure to change Budge Porter's life forever. Navigating a cramped kitchen in his apartment, even the littlest things take a long time.
Had to really dig in like that to get to the utensils.
The battle for Budge Porter began here when, in 1976, the third generation Husker took a really hard hit.
His thigh came up through, caught my head, and knocked my, off to the side and snapped my neck. My dreams were shattered right there.
But there have been friends and family, and now this.
Thanks, everybody.
A brand new house.
Isn't this amazing?
I know, everything's cold.
Filled with so many gifts that give a new kind of freedom.
This house is actually going to transform my life.
An elevator to take him downstairs.
Oh, man. I want you to see this.
A therapy pool. State-of-the-art technology.
The Budge can come in, hit one button, turn all the lights off in the house or on, create zones, or it can work from his iPhone, his iPad.
This is longtime friend and builder Brad Brown. He created Porter's brand new barrier-free home.
There's no step into the shower, wider doors, outlets farther up off the floor.
Dozens of contractors and donors who made it happen, who say Budge always somehow made it work. Now they'll make it work for Budge.
There's no way I can thank these people enough. It's just a lot of kindness. It's more than I can say.
And you can get a tour of Budge's home this weekend. The builder wants to open up the house so others will build similar homes. A $5 donation will get you in, and that goes to the Budge Porter Foundation to help build more barrier-free homes. Back to you.
Thanks, Natalie.